Guys, so now that we're in SolidWorks Visualize, all I've done so far is just import my assembly into Visualize, and the only thing I did is I created the materials that I'm gonna be using just to make it quick, and I set my camera how I want it. So that's the only thing I did. So to import it, you can just click on your file and import model and parts, or you can drag your assembly into Visualize. Anyone works. So now that this is the material we add in SolidWorks and the materials has been import, so I'm just going to go into accurate mode just to so we can see what we're working with. So these are the materials that our materials from SolidWorks came in. We can either work with this material and just adjust the texture mapping on it. But for mine, I'm just gonna use SolidWorks has some pretty cool, Visualize has some pretty cool material, wood material, which I've added to my appearance actually. So I'm just gonna start dragging my material on it. So I'll drag the wood. Make sure I set all my materials for my wood. Good. So now, then the next thing we need to do is the glass. I've made the wine glass material, and I'm just gonna drag it. And these are pretty much the wine glass from Solid. I mean, the glass from SolidWorks Visualize. I didn't really change much. These are the values I have, and the color is pretty much the same as the last tutorial I did on the wine glass. So it's gonna be the same thing, the wine bottle, just gonna drag it to that. And for that top, we're just gonna do something of that color for it. And for these rings, we're just to use this chrome material, and we're just gonna make those rim chrome. I still have a ring over there because I don't want to mess with my camera. I'm just gonna go into my camera and go to the other camera I have just to be able to move things around. So I'm just gonna zoom up a little bit and go back to my appearance, and I'm just gonna add the ring material to this material. And maybe I could switch to fast mode just to give me enough room to zoom in and out, because it's a little bit slow because I'm working in accurate mode. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go to fast mode just to give me room to work with. And one more. Good. So once it seems like we've added all our materials, so the next thing, and I'm just gonna go back to accurate mode, and I'm gonna go to my camera and switch back to that camera. So we've added all our material, it looks pretty good. The next thing we need to do is go into our scene, and I'm using the chrome scene, so it comes straight with SolidWorks Visualize. You just add the chrome scene or whatever scene you want, you prefer. And under our appearance, I'm just gonna right click. I'm gonna delete all unused appearance. It seems like this is being used somewhere. I'm just gonna click this, copy, assign. So that will assign it to wherever it's being used, and I can right click, delete on unused. So that's deleted. Good. So the next thing we wanna do is add a decal to our wine bottle. So just like we did in the last tutorial, we can right click new. I already made one, but I'm just gonna show you just real quick how to make one. Right click, new decal. We go to where our picture is, which is this, and maybe I will switch to fast mode, and I will drag my decal there. So now I can click on my object manipulation to scale, and I want to scale my decal down. And as you can see, my decal is pointing the wrong way, and you can rotate it with this green gizmo. And just pretty much adjust it however you want. So that's pretty much how you do the decal. And once you're done, you can create, just like in the last tutorial, create a new appearance with all white and you can give it the clear coat and clear coat roughness you want, and drag it to the decal, just like so, just to give the decal a little bit to make it shiny and look more realistic, as opposed to it being just dull. So that's what we see over here. You see the white dot on it. So I'm gonna delete this decal, and I'm just gonna show the one I've made. So I'm gonna show that decal. Maybe when I go back to my accurate mode, I should see it. So yeah, so the decal I've made is right there, and I can click on that decal. And if you want the logo to be more out in the open, you can just adjust it. I may adjust it later, but I'm just trying to show you real quick. That's just how you make the decal. So once we add everything, everything looks good. And in our scene, we have that, and we can add a back plate to this. So I right click, new black back plate, and I found this picture on Google. It's a picture of a bar. It looks pretty cool. So we're just gonna add the back plate and the back plate, and we wanna make sure it fills the background and fit camera to back scale. I mean back plate, sorry. So once we have that, the next thing we wanna do is go to our camera. I mean, we can leave it this way, but I always like using 1920 by 1080. So when I go back to that, it adjusted it. Click OK. I adjusted it so I can go back to my scene and my back plate, and I will click fill, so that way everything is fill, so that way there isn't that white spot on the edge. So that's pretty much it. Then the next thing, we go to our camera. Yeah, for the post processing, we adjust that, and once we adjust all the values the way we want, and the next thing we're just gonna do is render. So you can, I always like turning this back to preview mode, and I just click render, and I'll render it, and I'll save it to where I need to save it at. And that will pretty much be the whole workflow of doing the wine bottle holder with the wine and the decal and everything. As always, thanks for watching, guys. If there's anything I could have done better, please let me know in the comment section, and have a nice day. Bye.